सो टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज वेक्टर। ऑलराइट, सो व्हाट आर वेक्टर्स बेसिकली? सो प्लीज पे अटेंशन। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डायरेक्शन, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डायरेक्शन physical quantities are of two types. Physical quantities are of two types. Okay, number one, scalar. Number two, vectors. Okay, so on the basis of direction, physical quantities are of two types, scalar, vector. Now, what are scalar quantities? So, scalar quantities are those quantities which can be fully expressed by their unit and magnitude only, and direction is not needed. So these are the quantities, these are the quantities which can be fully expressed by their unit and magnitude, unit and magnitude, and direction is not needed. Direction is not needed. For example, if a person says that his height is 7 feet, you don't need to ask in which direction. Height means height of a person. Okay. Similarly, if a person says that his weight is 80 kg, then you don't need to ask in which direction. Weight is 80 kg and that will be evenly distributed in his entire body, right? So such quantities are scalar quantities. Example of scalar quantities, let me tell you, mass, length, time, etc. Quantities are scalar. All seven fundamental physical quantities are scalar. You can write that also. All seven fundamental physical quantities are All seven fundamental physical quantities are scalar. Okay. So this was all about scalar. Now we are going to talk about vectors. And what is their specialty? How to deal with them? So all these things. So these are the quantities which require, these are the quantities which require direction along with, these are the quantities which require direction along with unit and magnitude, unit and magnitude to be fully expressed. To be fully expressed. Okay. So there are some quantities for which you need to give direction. You need to give direction also to be fully expressed. Okay. For example, you are exerting a force on car. Now that force can be from backward to front also. That force can be from front to back also. That force can be side. Car will be moving or not, it will be dependent on in which direction the force is being exerted. So force is a vector quantity. Example, force, velocity, acceleration, etc. So there are many vector quantities. Now, just to give you more insight about vectors, for example, you and your friend, you are playing, okay, and you closed your eyes and your friend went 50 meters away and went into hiding 50 meters. Now a third person was observing. So after your friend went for hiding, you asked that third person, sir, please tell me now where that fellow has gone. If you say that he has gone away, now that 50 meter can be in any direction, any direction. In fact, if you draw a circle of 50 meter radius, if you draw a circle of 50 meter radius, maintaining center at the point where you or your friend has left, then that friend can be found anywhere on that 50 meter circle, right?
Yes,
you cannot find just by knowing the 50 meter. But if you are being told that 50 meter along, let's say north, along south, along east, along west, then you can go and easily find the person, right? So as direction is going to be added, accuracy of understanding of that physical quantity will be increased. Let me give you another example. Suppose there is a war going to happen between India and Pakistan. Okay, just taking one example. So war is going to happen between India and Pakistan, and you are the grenadier in the sense you are going to handle the cannon. Okay, now that cannon can fire a shell up to 500 kilometers. So what you did, you put the shell in the cannon and you fed the distance as 500 kilometers and you wanted that shell to land at 500 kilometer away. But you forgot to mention the direction. You forgot to mention the direction that those 500 kilometers will be inside Pakistan. And you fired the cannon. Now you tell me, when you have not mentioned the direction, then that shell can go anywhere at any place which is 500 kilometers from the firing point. That place can be inside India also. Would you like to do such stupidity? Yes, you should not do, right? So that is the importance of vectors. But if you would have put 500 kilometers and specific coordinates of place in Pakistan, and put the button tuck, you'll be sure that now the place is gone, finished. Correct? That is the importance of vector. Only unit and magnitude, 500 kilometer is not sufficient. Only 500 kilometer is not sufficient. But along with 500 kilometers, you also need to tell that which direction for that vector quantities are important. This is just one example to make you realize the importance of direction. Importance of direction in common life, right? Okay, so this was vector quantities. Now, what is the way to represent? So please write representation of vector quantities. Representation of vector quantities. So vector quantities are represented above the quantity. Why an arrow above the quantity, or you can say symbol above the symbol? For example, A vector, P vector. So whenever you see an arrow above the symbol, then you realize that you are dealing with a vector quantity. All right. So this is force vector. Vector quantities are represented by an arrow above it, and this kind of representation is called symbolic representation. Symbolic representation. So basically, which symbol you are going to use to represent a vector? So whatever symbol you are using, that kind of representation is called symbolic representation. Next comes geometric representation. So what is geometric representation? So geometrically, a vector is represented by a line segment like this. Okay. Now, the place from which it is starting is called tail, and the end of arrow is called head, or terminus. Okay, so the starting point is origin, end point is terminus, or starting point is tail, end point is head. Okay, direction of a vector. So first of all, please write geometrically geometrically a vector is represented by geometrically a vector is represented by an arrow geometrically a vector is represented by an arrow starting point is called origin or tail and end point is called terminus or tail. Okay.
That should be head, no?
Huh?
So the ending point should be tail.
Ending point should be tail. You want me to change the representation?
So he meant terminus or head.
Just a second. Terminus or head. Yeah. Now it's fine. All right. Now, direction of a vector. Direction of a vector is always from tail to head. Direction of a vector is always from tail to head. Direction of a vector is always from tail to head. Okay. Mind it. Now, in real life is equal to vector which you are drawing. Okay. Example. Please write size of original vector. May not be equal to its geometrical representation on paper. Okay. In fact, in 99.9% cases, it is not equal. In 99.9% cases, the actual vector is not equal to geometrical representation. Okay. For example, suppose you want to draw a vector from Margaon to Panjim. So when you are trying to draw a vector from Margaon to Panjim, I am assuming the distance roughly as 30 kilometers. Okay. Now, are you going to draw a vector of length 30 kilometer in your copy? No, it is not needed. So what you can do, pay attention. You can draw 6 centimeter. I know it is more than 6 centimeter. Okay, so you can draw a vector of length 6 centimeter in your copy. Starting point is Margao, end point is Panjim. So your MP vector is equal to Margao to Panjim vector. Margao to Panjim vector. Okay, so just by drawing a line of 6 centimeter, you have represented Margao to Panjim vector. Okay, very nice, very nice. Now, what are speciality of a vector? What are speciality of a vector? So let us talk further. A vector has magnitude as well as direction. There is a question from student. Okay, Anand is saying, sir, in this case, if we change the order of the alphabet, then direction of arrow will be also changed. Not just changed, Anand, it will be reversed. It will be reversed if we change the order. Keshav is asking, sir, can we represent vector as a cap even? Keshav, that cap is basically a special type of vector. Vector as a cap. No, that is a special type of vector, and for a special condition you use that cap symbol. I'll tell you that what is that cap symbol. Okay, but the point here is a vector has magnitude as well as direction. For example, in our previous example which we took, of Margao to Panjim vector, or you can say MP vector, the direction was from Margao to Panjim. Okay. And magnitude was 30 kilometer. Here in symbol we took it as 6 centimeter, so that is fine, that can be done. Okay, so but a vector consists of magnitude as well as direction. Be very clear about it. What is the size of vector? That is also important. Number two, what is the direction of vector? That is also important, very important. Parth is saying it's unit vector. Very nice, Parth. Very nice. Now Ananya is saying, but by seeing the geometrical representation, we can't say that it is just by looking at your passport size photo or anyone's passport size photo, we cannot decide that how big the person is in real life, right? But even with photo, you can find out a lot about any person. Just by a passport size photo, you can find a lot about any person. But there are many things which you cannot find out just by looking at passport size photo also. You cannot find out what is the blood group of the person, what is the total mass of the person. You cannot find out all these things, right? And nowadays when you have so much, photos are just for namesake. The person you see in real life and the person you see in WhatsApp DP or Insta or whatever is entirely different. Okay, filters work. So is there some way of indicating actual distance? For that you have to mention the size. Now Ananya is saying by multiplying or something. Yes, that method is being used, that you need to multiply by some constant or something, and then you can find. Okay. Any other doubt, anyone? Good. So the point is that a vector has magnitude as well as direction. Now the important thing is, pay attention. Even if you change the direction of a vector or magnitude of a vector or both, a vector can be changed by changing its magnitude or direction or both. Okay, or both. Now let me tell you, Margao to Penjim vector is not same as Margao to GMC vector, because so direction though are same, but Margao to Penjim vector and Margao to GMC vector are not same. Why? Because Margao to GMC vector is smaller in size. Margao to GMC vector is smaller in size, right? So these two are not same. Now suppose you took distance as same, equal, and in one vector you went to Margao to Penjim, another vector you used in Margao to Vasco, and you went in deeper inside the Vasco, so that in that case the two vectors are not equal. Why? Because direction has been changed. Okay, understood? So even if you are changing the magnitude or direction or both, a vector is changed. Okay, so let me now a little bit give you explanation about magnitude of vector. What is magnitude? Magnitude of a vector. So first of all, magnitude of a vector is the numerical value of the vector. Magnitude of a vector represents the numerical value of the vector. Magnitude of a vector represents the numerical value of the vector. Okay, for example, in Margao to Penjim vector, numerical value was 30 kilometers. So that is the magnitude. In our previous example, in which we fired a cannon, okay, and the displacement was 500 kilometers. So the numerical value of vector or magnitude of vector in that case was 500 kilometers. All right. So that is the numerical value. Okay. So if direction is removed from a vector, from a vector, we are left with magnitude. We are left with magnitude of the vector. So if you don't talk about the direction of vector, all right, you only mention the numerical value, then whatever is the numerical value is the magnitude of vector. Okay, so if a vector is the vector, if a vector is the vector, then its magnitude represented by its magnitude is represented by a. Okay, if a vector is the vector, then its magnitude is represented by a without arrow or a vector with two parallel lines on both sides. That is called magnitude symbol or mod symbol. Okay, any doubt, any question? Magnitude of a vector is always positive. Magnitude of a vector. Magnitude of a vector is always positive. So magnitude of a vector is always positive number. Mind it. Okay. Magnitude of a vector is always positive number. That is also important. Yes, magnitude alone is scalar. Magnitude alone is scalar. When magnitude is mixed with the direction or added with the direction, then only it becomes vector. You can note this also. Magnitude alone is scalar. When added with direction, then it becomes vector. Okay. Or in other words, you can say that if you snatch direction from a vector, then you get its magnitude. Okay. If you snatch, this is not a technical term. Okay. This is just for your understanding. This is just for your understanding. Don't write this definition in. So if you snatch direction from a vector. If you snatch direction from a vector, you get, what do you get? Magnitude. It's magnitude. Okay. So basically, when direction is removed from a vector, what's scalar quantity? And that scalar quantity is called mag. Okay. All right. Good.
Yes.
Good. I hope there is no doubt up to this. All right. Example. If a vector Goa, Mumbai is, I'm assuming just a number 500 kilometer GM vector. Okay. GM vector is 500. And kilometer. Find its magnitude. Find its magnitude. So how much is its magnitude? Please find. Question is very easy. So what you can write is mod of GM vector is equal to GM is equal to 500 kilometer. Okay. That will be your answer. That will be your answer. Okay. Good. 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 Now there is something called unit vector. So let us talk about that also. So what is unit vector? If a vector is divided by its magnitude, if a vector is divided by its magnitude, we get unit vector. So unit vector is represented by unit vector is represented by a cap symbol above vector symbol. Or you can say, rather than vector symbol, above physical quantity. Okay. So if a vector is, yes, please pay attention. If a vector is divided by its magnitude, if a vector is divided by its magnitude, we get unit vector. Unit vector is represented by a cap symbol, cap. So what is cap? Let me show you. This is cap which you are seeing here above A. Okay. So if then unit vector for A is a cap, and a cap is equal to a vector upon A. Okay. Unit vector is equal to, let me write formula also. Unit vector is equal to vector upon its magnitude. Unit vector is equal to vector upon its magnitude. All right, please note. Any doubt, any question?
No, sir.
So unit vector is only the direction. Yes, Ananya, you are right. Unit vector is only the direction. Okay. In fact, there is one more interesting thing. Magnitude of a unit vector is 1. Magnitude of a unit vector is 1. In fact, that can also be used to define unit vector. And how can you define that? Unit vector is a vector of magnitude 1. So a vector of magnitude 1 is called this can be used as definition for unit vector. A vector of magnitude 1 is called unit vector. A vector of magnitude 1 is called unit vector. A vector of magnitude 1 is called unit vector. All right. Remember that. A vector of magnitude 1 is vector. Now, one very key point. We all know about x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, right? So this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is z-axis. Actually, it should be, z-axis should be outward of the plane, but we cannot draw outward. So we draw it like this. Now, unit vector along x-axis is I cap. Unit vector along x-axis is I cap. Unit vector along y-axis is J cap. And unit vector along z-axis is K cap. Remember that, everyone. Okay. So please write unit vectors along x-axis comma y-axis and z-axis or I cap and K cap respectively. Okay. Now be very clear. These symbols I cap, J cap and K cap are assigned to I, J and K, or you can say X, Y and Z axis. You and I cannot change them. Okay. Keep that thing in mind. You and I cannot change them. All right. That cannot be changed. Okay. Remember that. Noted, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt, any question? Sir, why only I cap, J cap and K cap? It is by convention, Warren. It is not decided by me or you or any normal person. It is decided by the scientific community worldwide. When they came together for deciding, then it was decided that, okay, I cap, it is given to X axis. J cap, it is given to Y axis. K cap, it is given to Z axis. Decided, already decided. Okay. I, J and K, these all are small caps, Selena. These are small caps. Okay, Sarah and Selena. These are small I, small J, small K. Okay. All right. Any other question? All right. So just to tell you, ask you how much is the value of mod of I cap? How much is the value of mod of I cap? So this will be how much? This will be how much? Who is going to tell me this?
Sir, one.
Yes, it will be one because it's a unit vector. Okay. Good. So basically, mod of I is equal to mod of J cap, is equal to mod of K cap, is equal to mod of any other cap, is equal to one. Why? Because it's a unit vector. It's a unit vector. So basically, while you are assigning unit vectors for any physical quantity in any question, you are going to avoid giving them I cap, J cap, K cap. You are going to avoid them giving assigning I cap, J cap and K cap. Okay. I cap, J cap and K cap are pre-booked for. These are pre-booked for X direction, Y direction and Z direction. Okay. Good. Can we move further? All right. We'll be revisiting unit vectors once again later, but now we are going to move further. We are now going to talk about direction, or you can say angle between two vectors. Angle between two vectors. Angle between two vectors. Okay, So how to calculate the angle between two vectors? So suppose this is your A vector and this is your B vector. Okay. So when these are A vector, angle between them, all right. So angle between two vectors is the smaller angle between them when they are connected by their tails. When they are connected by their tails. So please note, angle between two vectors. Angle between two vectors is the smaller angle. Is the smaller angle between them when they are connected by their tails. Connected by their tails. Okay. So when two vectors are connected by their tails, then whatever is the smaller angle between them will be considered as the angle between those two vectors. Vectors must be connected by their tails. Okay. Let me give you question. Please give answers. You need to give answer of find angle between number one, A vector and B vector, number two, B vector and C vector, number three, okay, please find.
Sudan.
Okay.
In first case, we need to find between A and B. So what we can do, listen very carefully. I'm going to shift this B here. Okay. I'm going to shift this B parallel to it. And this angle is totally 60. So 60 angle AB will be 60 minus 30 is equal to 30. So angle AB will be 30 degree. Angle AB will be 30 degree. All right. Now let us talk about angle BC. So this time I'm bringing B, or you can say shifting B parallel to itself and connecting to the tail of C. So this is B vector. This is T plus 45. So angle BC is equal to 60 plus 45 is equal to 105 degree. Okay. Now in third case, you want to find between A and C. So I need to shift A. So when I'm shifting A parallel to itself, you can see I am showing it by blue color. So this angle is 30. So 45 plus 30 is equal to 75. degree. That is the answer. That is the answer. Okay, please pay attention. Any doubt, any question, anyone? Any doubt, any question, anyone? Good. Sagar is saying screen is frozen. Okay. Shavi, have you noted? Sagar, have you noted? Shavi and Sagar, have you noted?
Yes, sir.
Yes, she's saying good. Yes, you have noted. Yes, have you noted? Next question. All right. This is and this is B vector. This angle is 60 degree. Question is find angle between A vector and B vector. So you need to find angle between Please answer. Can you brief us on how the test is going to be conducted this Sunday? Your test will be conducted on Teams, and the way you are given your DPP question, in a similar way, your test will be conducted on that similar lines. Okay. You need to answer your respective questions in 3 hours. That's what you need to do. confusion. In this, first of all, you need to shift either A or B. This time I am going to shift B. And why I am shifting? So that both can be connected by their tails. So this is your B vector. This is your A vector. And this angle was given as 60. So our angle here will be this. And that will be 120 degrees. Theta is equal to 80. Why? Because we need to connect them by their tail. We need to connect them by their tail. Okay. All right. Now, Yash is saying, sir, if you have taken PCMB, then also your test will be on same date. Okay. Don't worry about that. Keshav is saying, sir, will the question be combined of all three subjects or separately for each? It will be combined for all three subjects. Paper will be combined. Yes, is saying, sir, if we have taken PCMB, then how will we get the test question? Depending on whether your priority is IIT or medicine. If your priority is medicine, then your paper will be of PCB, BZ basically, botany zoology. If your priority is of IIT, then your paper will be of PCM. Okay, yes. What will be informed? Don't worry about that, Rudra. How must we submit the test? By pressing a button. Okay, Vanya. You need to just press a button and your test will be submitted. Nada is saying, sir, which test are they talking about? I am new here. In any place, when you go to study, Nada, they take test to assess that how much you are learning, how well you are studying at home. So it will be that kind of test. Objective test this will be. Sir, do we need to maintain a separate notebook for all? See, if you want to excel in competition, then you should maintain. Okay. This Sunday we are having a subjective test. If it is subjective, then it will be subjective, yes, depending on what is mentioned in your timetable. Ananya is asking Nada, acha, she is responding basically. On Sunday we have a subjective test. You can check the timetable. Okay. Not Sunday, it is Saturday, right? Ananya is saying Sunday. Okay, they all are discussing amongst each other. Can you please, sir, what told about the test? I could not hear him. Okay. Ananya, please answer, Yash. Which subject test will be? Very nice. We'll be talking about world politics. It will be PCM or PCB, Selena. Sir, the test portion contains binomial theorem. Are we taught this? In mathematics, if it is taught, then it's fine. In mathematical tools, it is not a big deal. Don't worry. Selena is also new here. Very nice, Selena. Welcome. Manas is saying, sir, I won't be able to submit the hard copy of the test every week. Ananya is saying, sir, said the test will be of 30 marks and we need to answer the question in the allotted time. Okay. 30 marks each subject. Okay. Selena, it will be physics, chemistry, botany, and geology. Thank you, Sagar. And maths too. Timing. Maths also. Timing this. Okay. Thanks for helping me out. Manas is saying, what if I want to give test of biology as well as maths? You can give, Manas. Who can stop you? If a person has the keenness to learn, who can stop that person? Okay. Nobody can stop you, Manas. Nobody. You can answer. All right. So this was angle between two vectors. This was angle between two vectors.
Now we need to go further. We need to go further. Please pay attention. And now we are going to talk about addition of vectors. Addition of vectors. Now listen very carefully. Addition of vector. Okay, everyone, please stop your chit-chatting. Please stop your chit-chatting. And is a addition of numbers. Addition of vectors is different than addition of simple numbers. Okay, how it is different, we'll talk about it. How it is different, we'll talk about it. So what is addition of vector? So pay attention. Suppose this is your A vector and this is your B vector. Okay. So A vectors and two B vector are two different vectors, and these are such a way that tail of second vector, their resultant, listen very carefully, their resultant will be from tail of first vector to head of second vector. That is how you find addition of vectors. Okay, so please write, if two vectors such that tail of second vector starts from head of first vector. Tail of second vector starts from head of first vector. Then their resultant will be from tail of first vector to head of second vector. Okay, now let me tell you, your A and B is second vector here. Okay, and now read the definition. Everyone, please read the definition and try to understand whether you are able to get it or not. Any doubt, any question? So you need to understand this definition very clearly. Everyone, please. Tail of second vector. So in this example, what is happening? The tail of second is starting from the head of first, right? And if that is the case, the resultant is starting from the tail of first and ending at head of second. So what you can write is, please pay attention everyone, R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector. R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector. Here trade off and B vector. Here R vector is the resultant of A vector and B vector. Okay. Now what is interesting part in vector addition, let me tell you. In normal maths, when you add 2 plus 2 becomes 4. In vector mathematics, or you can say vector algebra, 2 plus 2 may not necessarily be 4. 2 plus 2 may not necessarily be 4. Okay. That is the special part of vector, interesting part of vector. Keep that thing in your mind. Okay. Vector algebra is interesting. Vector algebra is interesting in that sense. Okay. Please note. Noted everyone?
Yes.
Noted. Good. Now, how to find its numerical value? This thing in the next class, okay? As of now, you have written R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector, correct? But by writing this, are you able to realize that how much will be the value of R? No. You cannot identify the value of R by this formula. So basically, theoretically, this definition is correct, but to use it in a practical way, it is not yet sufficient. So what we need to do? We need to find a formula using which we can find the actual value when we are getting two vectors added, okay? A quick question. Let me just give you a quick question based on angle between two vectors, because we have studied only that topic so far. So this is your A vector and this angle is 45 degrees. This is your B vector and this angle is 30 degrees. And this is your C vector. This angle is 60 degrees. Find angle between number one, A vector and B vector. Number two, A vector and C vector. Number three, B vector and C vector.
105 and 210.
Okay, everyone, please pay attention. For A vector and B vector, what we need to do, I am shifting A vector here, and this is 45 degree, this is 30, so this remaining will be 180 okay, so angle AB is equal to 180 minus 45 plus 30, and that becomes 105 degree. So those who are giving answer as 105, they are absolutely correct. So this was A and B. Now let me shift A at C's place. So this is A vector. This is 45. So angle AC is equal to 45 plus 60, and that also becomes 105 degree. Now comes angle between B and C. Angle between B and C. So this time I am shifting C. Okay. This angle is 60 degree, okay, and this angle is 30 degree, all right, and 30 degree from this side. So if you see how much angle is this, this is 150 degree, this is 150, all right. So angle can be, now pay attention, angle can be, how much will be this? Will be, so angle BC is equal to 120 plus 30 is equal to 150. Answer. Those who are giving 210, read the formula, read the definition which I gave you. The definition told the smaller angle between the A and B. Now you tell me, 150 is smaller or 210 is smaller? You tell me, or 210, you tell me. The smaller angle is 150. So we can go like this and we can measure the smaller angle. Here, I did not say that you need to calculate in clockwise or anti-clockwise. In fact, you can go anti-clockwise also. You can go anti-clockwise also. All right. Your answer will be 150 in this case. I hope you have understood, and that is enough for today. Thank you so much.